In this video, we will discuss the role of environmental stress in contributing to mental health problems in 22q11 deletion syndrome. Corrado and me each will discuss separate parts on this topic.
In the first section, we will present some recent evidence on the relationship between environmental stress and mental health disturbances. In the second section, we will discuss some evidence concerning potential mechanisms that could account for increased vulnerability to stress in 22q.
And in a final section, we will discuss some recommendations concerning management of environmental stress in 22q11 deletion syndrome.
A large number of studies suggest that mental health problems, including mood disturbances, anxiety, or even psychosis, result from a combination of genetic factors and environmental factors. Indeed, according to this model, which you find depicted in this graph, genetic factors, including the 22q11 deletion, can act as a first hit that increases vulnerability to mental health problems. Environmental factors can then act as a second hit that can partially explain why only some individuals who are genetically vulnerable actually develop mental health problems. Until recently, however, we have known little concerning the role of environmental factors in 22q. Researchers have hence recently attempted to understand whether exposure to environmental stress could contribute to negative mental health outcomes in 22q. In this perspective, a first study from the University of Geneva attempted to characterize the level of exposure to stressful life events in 22q using a retrospective questionnaire. In this context, a stressful event is defined as a situation that requires an individual to adapt to a changing environment. And in this perspective, stress is not only related to negative events, such as witnessing the loss of a family member, but also potentially positive events, such as birth of a sibling or moving to a larger house. Researchers found that individuals with 22q reported being exposed to fewer stressful life events compared to control subjects. An interpretation for this finding is that individuals with 22q and their families attempt to limit the exposure to stressful situations in order to shield them from the negative consequences of these events. Indeed, despite being exposed to a fewer number of stressful life events, stress exerted a higher impact on mental health disturbances, including in particular anxiety and mood symptoms, in individuals with 22q compared to healthy controls. Also, individuals reported higher levels of perceived stress and negative emotions. These results suggest an increased vulnerability to stress in 22q11. Indeed, the prevalence of post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD, in 22q has been reported to be lower compared to other populations. However, it should be noted that this was not the specific focus of researchers. Recently, a group at Maastricht University explored the occurrence of traumatic events and PTSD in 22q. PTSD and related conditions appear to be more prevalent in 22q compared to the general population. This might have been previously overshadowed or attributed to other psychiatric disorders. Clinicians should hence be alerted to PTSD in 22q in order to minimize the psychiatric burden and improve quality of life. Also, specific treatments for PTSD can be beneficial in people with 22q. Recently, researchers have employed novel technologies such as smartphones to have a more precise understanding of the relationship between stress and mental health in 22q. By using smartphones, individuals can report the level of stress they are exposed to in different moments of the day and in relation to particular situations that they are experiencing, such as interacting with others or performing in work or related tasks. This approach demonstrated that individuals with 22q describe social situations as being more stressful. Importantly, vulnerability to environmental stress was associated with the presence of psychotic symptoms. These results suggest that 22q may be associated with an increased vulnerability to environmental stress, including, in particular, social stress. This might contribute to increased risk of mental health problems. Researchers are currently attempting to understand what mechanisms account for such increased vulnerability to stress. Indeed, understanding such mechanisms will be important for formulating treatment recommendations. Firstly, researchers from the University of Geneva hypothesized that the difference in types of strategies that individuals use to cope with stress could influence their vulnerability to stressful situations. Examples of positive coping strategies include, for instance, putting things into perspective or asking for support. while more negative, less adaptive coping strategies include blaming oneself or thinking excessively about what happened. Results show that individuals with 22q tended to use much fewer positive coping strategies compared to healthy controls. Moreover, individuals with 22q who used more negative coping strategies were also significantly more vulnerable to the effects of stress, both in terms of major stressful events and minor stressors in their daily lives. These results suggest that coping strategies influence vulnerability to stress in 22q and could therefore represent a promising target for future psychological interventions. Researchers are also focusing on neurobiological mechanisms that might contribute to increased vulnerability to stress. Indeed, in healthy subjects, the ability to cope with stress relies on a multitude of reactions in the body, many of which are orchestrated by a system that is known as the hypothalamus-pituitary-adrenal axis. In this perspective, researchers studied the development of a key component of this system, which is known as the pituitary gland. What they found was that individuals with 22q presented a decline in the volume of this key structure, specifically during adolescence. Individuals who had this declining volume also reported a reduced ability to deal with minor daily stress and were more at risk of developing several forms of mental health problems. These findings suggest that alterations in the way the body deals with stress could make some individuals with 22q more vulnerable to the negative effects of stress. Along these lines, researchers from the University of Maastricht found that differences in levels of stress hormones that are responsible for dealing with stress could result in a higher level of psychopathology. Indeed, such alterations have been previously reported in other psychiatric disorders such as PTSD, psychosis, or even mood disorders. These results suggest that the same alteration in the ability of the body to deal with stress could affect adults with 22q. In the future, biological measures might help identify individuals who present such heightened vulnerability to stress in order to develop more personalized treatment strategies.
How can these findings inform treatment and recommendations for individuals and families affected by 22q11 deletion syndrome? The knowledge that environmental factors might modulate clinical outcome in 22q11 deletion syndrome opens exciting possibilities for informing future treatment strategies. PTSD and trauma-related disorders can be treated very effectively, so it is important that the symptoms are recognized properly and early. Screening for environmental stress, both in terms of minor daily stressors and life events leading to PTSD. For example, have there been any new colleagues at work? Has bullying at school taken place? In 22q11 deletion syndrome, PTSD and related symptoms may be overshadowed by or attributed to other psychiatric disorders, so it's very important to ask for it and look out for it. Trauma-specific treatment like EMDR, which means eye movement desensitization and reprocessing, in case of PTSD or trauma-related symptoms may be very helpful and has been successfully applied in people with 22q11 deletion syndromes. Active screening of mental health symptoms, including in particularly anxiety and psychotic symptoms during periods of increasing stress. In particular, the development of anxiety and feeling of a reduced ability to cope with minor daily stressors are warning signs that might warrant specific treatment. Development of coping strategies through psychological training. Personalized approach aimed at assessing the balance between external demands and internal resources. So to conclude, we have learned that trauma, stress, and related disorders are very common in 22q11 deletion syndrome and need special attentions. Once recognized, they can be treated effectively and may be able to prevent other future psychological problems.